student throw his watch out of the window?
I don't know why, but can I have it?
He wanted to know if time flies.
Haha, very funny. But can I still have it?
Sure, while you look for that, I'll start the news. There's a Super Mileage Club meeting today after school at 2 o'clock in the metal shop. Check out this clip that explains about the awesome club and a great opportunity for anyone interested.
The Super Mileage Competition entails an engineering project for our high school students.
To build a one-man, fuel-efficient car. Very light, very aerodynamic, terrific rolling resistance, good engines, to see how far they can go on a gallon of gas.
We used to do it as clubs, but it's a group of kids. You got to build the vehicle, and the goal is not speed. You know, you go to a raceway, you think you're racing for speed. It has little to do with speed. You're just trying to build the most efficient vehicle.
It's hundreds of schools that have been in it at one point or another.
We weigh the fuel, enter the data for the fuel, send that data then to a timer.
They measure it out and get your results.
Calculating their miles.
Yep. You also got to get 6 runs to qualify, and each qualifier after that just keeps getting better and better. So you could have one bad run and that could ruin your whole weekend.
Tell them we have to have a brake on the vehicle, but you should never step on it. I mean, the whole time you're out there, unless there's an emergency, you know, if you're putting your foot on the brake, you're not increasing your gas mileage.
You know what? There's 121 cars and there's 121 different cars. Not one of them are the same. They're all their own. They're all three-wheel cars, most of them. And it's either one wheel in front or one wheel in back. And, you know, it's just, again, it's a smattering of everything. We've had cars made out of 2x4s, PVC pipe, aluminum, steel, composites.
I learned how to use fiberglass, like the construction type, carbon fiber. We vacuum magged our chassis.
Our steering is called Ackerman steering, and it makes a perfect X with the front two tires in the back.
We got kids out there trying to run fuel injection. Not on our team, but on other teams. Who knows? We got kids running diesel out there, fuel cells. And there's all kinds of things going on.
We partnered with Briggs. Well, this is our 25th anniversary, and they've been in it since the very, very beginning. They've been our major sponsor. All of the cars are Briggs & Stratton powered.
The kids are always coming up with new ideas, and if we use one of their ideas, that gets them very excited.
You may not know each other at the beginning, but then you like build your like teamwork together.
And it's hands-on. It's engineering. It's problem solving. It's critical thinking. It's all those things.
The boys' soccer team is off to a great start. They won their last two games against Cannon Falls and Rockford. They have another game tonight in Delano. Good luck, guys. And the tennis team has a match today at home against Litchfield. Come out and cheer on the girls. Junior Powder Puff shirts will be available at the table inside the main entrance today and tomorrow after school. Come pick up yours if you ordered one. Attention Spanish Club members. Money for shirts and club fees are due by tomorrow. The shirts will take about 2 weeks once the order is placed. If you are unable to attend the first meeting, send Senora Potter an email for more information. The Spanish Club is selling Mexican lollipops. Lollipops will be purchased after 3 in Senora Potter's room or a Spanish Club member. Is your team, club, or organization participating in homecoming parade? Contact Lisa Gies in the office if you want to participate. Here's Brandon with the rest of the news.
If you are bringing a guest to homecoming dance, you must turn in a dance contract by Thursday, September 24th, by 2:30 p.m. Dance contracts are available online or in the forms rack outside the office. One guest per student. Forms must be turned in ahead of time and will not be accepted at the dance. Homecoming dance details. It's going to be Friday, September 25th from 9 to midnight. Doors open at 9 and will close 10. And $5 per person. Please bring your school picture ID to get in. Concession stand will be open. Guests need to have a dance contract turned in by Thursday, September 24th. Dance contracts will not be accepted at the dance. Monday is going to be the Powerpuff game at Trojan Stadium at 7:30 p.m. Wednesday is going to be the float building at the bus garage from 5:30 to 8:30 p.m. Friday is going to be the Pep Fest coronation in the gym at 11:15. Parade at 1, football game at 7 at Trojan Stadium. Homecoming dance in the gym from 9 to midnight. Homecoming week dress-up days is begin Monday with classes color day. Seniors are going to be black, juniors red, sophomores blue, freshmen yellow, and staff green. Students interested in riding a fan bus to the football game at Red Wing Friday night should sign up in the activities office. Price is $6, and you must sign up by the end of the day today. Attention sophomores. Jocelyn's will be here on Monday, September 21st, to meet with all the sophomores in the auditorium from 8:35 to 9:05 regarding class rings. Please report directly to the auditorium at the beginning of the second hour. After the meeting, report to your second period class. And finally, please remember that today is an early release today, and other schools are in session, so avoid the other buildings. What's for lunch, Mary?
Today's menu is chicken and gravy, whole grain baking powder biscuit, steamed green beans, pickled beets, mixed fruit, and milk or taco bar.
Today's birthday shout out goes to Stephen Pexa, Hannah Schoenbauer, Chelsea Schmitz, Yvette Hansen, and Eva Barrier.
This just in, the cross country team is running at Hutch today. There is no fan bus available.
I'll be cheering for you from here, Mary. So listen for me.
Thanks, Nemo. See you tomorrow in Prig.
Oh, sometimes I get a good feeling, yeah. Never had before, no, no. And I just gotta tell you right now that I believe, I really do believe that something's gotta hold on me, yeah.